بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Our question today is common in Arab board, Saudi board, Jordan board, Egyptian board related to arrhythmia and supraventricular tachycardia or narrow complex tachycardia. So we'll see our question here. Which of the following heart rates most suggestive of supraventricular tachycardia in the newborn? This is the cardiac monitor and this is the ECG shows narrow complex tachycardia. Narrow complex tachycardia. So I have to differentiate between narrow complex tachycardia, it's related to sinus tachycardia or supraventricular tachycardia. And what is the normal heart rate for the newborn? And what is the normal heart rate for all the children? And when I will consider this is supraventricular tachycardia in the neonate, and when I will consider this is supraventricular tachycardia in all the children, based on the heart rate. In neonate, more than 220 beat per minute. More than that, I will consider supraventricular tachycardia. In all the children, if more than 180 beat per minute, I will consider the as supraventricular tachycardia. And there is other feature, we'll actually describe it now. So A, this is 180 beat per minute. This is four. If more than this number, I will consider it as supraventricular tachycardia in all the children. 230 beat per minute, this is the answer. B, this is the answer. This is if more than 220 beat per minute in neonate or infant, I will consider this one supraventricular tachycardia, or I will consider it as tachycardia. So 150 beat per minute, actually this is not the answer. 210 beat per minute, our limit is will be 220 beat per minute. More than that, I will consider it as tachycardia. So based on the pulse basic pediatric advanced life support, define or the supraventricular tachycardia depend on the age group. Based on the age group, infant heart rate is greater than what? 220 beat per minute. More than that, I will consider it as supraventricular tachycardia. In all the children, heart rate of the supraventricular tachycardia is greater than 180 beat per minute. What about the ECG finding? The ECG finding, it will demonstrate narrow complex tachycardia. And the B, it will be actually sometimes it will not present. And also it will be, there is without beat to beat variability, without beat to beat variability. And PR interval, it will be fixed. PR interval, it will be fixed. In stable actually patient, this is the management depending on the stability of the patient. Patient is stable or unstable. First of all, if you would like to interpret the supraventricular tachycardia, you have to define based on the heart rate. Based on the heart rate, our case is neonate, so the heart rate is more than 220 beat per minute. It is supraventricular or sinus tachycardia. So I have to differentiate between them. Then after you differentiate between them, you have to check for the reversible causes of the tachycardia. After you check the reversible causes of tachycardia, you have to check your patients is stable or unstable. Based on what? Based on the hemodynamics. Hemodynamics, this is blood pressure is maintained, this is stable. The blood pressure is not maintained or hemodynamical unstable or compromised patient alteration in the conscious level, this patient unstable. So we are dealing with patient, stable patient. So you have to go by vagal maneuver. Vagal maneuver, it will be the first treatment of choice. It will be ice. Do you have to put ice to the face or blowing through the actually occlude straw in older children? I'm talking about older children. This maneuver for older children. And after that, after you finish the vagal stimulation or vagal maneuver, you have to give pharmacological management. What is the pharmacological management? It will be adenosine. How much the dose? This is the drug of choice. It will be 0.1 milligram per kg up to 6 milligram. This is the first dose. If the patient is not respond to this dose, you have to double the dose to be 0.2 milligram per kg of the second dose up to 12 milligram. If no successful response to adenosine, and adenosine you have to give rapid and push, and you have to flush it with normal saline, it will be in the central line behind the heart to be more effective, because the half-life of the adenosine is very short, maybe 10 seconds. So you have to put it beside the heart and you have flush it, and you have to be in the central line or big vein, and you have to flush it with normal saline immediately. If no response, you have to double the dose to be 0.2 milligram per kg up to 12 milligram. If no response to adenosine, you have to give amiodarone. It will be 5 milligram per kg given over 20 to 60 minutes. Or if no response, you have to give procainamide 15 milligram per kg given over 30 to 60 minutes, or the next drug of choice. So supraventricular tachycardia, stable or unstable? Stable, pharmacological management, or you have to give vagal maneuver, then adenosine, and the adenosine should be in beside the heart in central line, and you have to push it and you have to flush it with normal saline immediately, because the half-life of the adenosine is very short. If no response, you have to double the dose. If the patient unstable, so you have to give cardioversion. If the patient, you can give sedation some to decrease this the pain, and 0.51 joule per kg. If no response, you have to double the dose. It will be 2 joules per kg. If there is IV access, and dose of adenosine can be given while you are sitting up for the cardioversion. So you have 2 points here you have to remember. The heart rate, if more than 220, this is supraventricular tachycardia in the neonate. If the heart rate more than 180 beat per minute, this is supraventricular tachycardia in older children. And depend on the stability of the patient. Patient is stable or unstable. Patient is stable, give vagal maneuver, then pharmacological management, adenosine, the first dose 0.1 milligram. If no response, you give the second dose 0.2 up to 12 milligram. If no response, it will be amiodarone and then procainamide. Unstable patient, cardioversion. How much is the dose? 0.5 to 1 joule per kg. If no response, you have to give the double the dose. It will be 2 joule per kg. So the first step, you have to classify the tachyarrhythmia. This tachyarrhythmia, based on what I will classify? Based on the PR. If the narrow complex QRS less than 0.09 second, this is almost, and the patient is stable usually, it will be supraventricular tachycardia or sinus tachycardia. If wide QRS more than 0.09 second, it's often unstable patient. It will be what? Ventricular tachycardia or supraventricular tachycardia with abnormal conduction. So the first step, you have to classify this tachyarrhythmia. This is narrow complex or wide complex QRS. If narrow complex, you have two differential diagnoses: sinus tachycardia and supraventricular tachycardia. And almost the patient, or usually the patient, it will be stable hemodynamics. But wide complex QRS, the usual or often it will be unstable hemodynamics patient. This is called supraventricular tachycardia with abnormal conduction or ventricular tachycardia. This is the first step to classify the tachycardia based on the PR: narrow complex or wide complex. Narrow complex, supraventricular tachycardia and sinus tachycardia. Wide complex, ventricular tachycardia or supraventricular tachycardia with abnormal conduction. Second step, so this case is narrow complex tachycardia. So I have two differential diagnoses. It will be sinus tachy or supraventricular tachy. How can I differentiate between the sinus tachy and supraventricular tachy? By the onset. In sinus tachy, it will be gradual. In supraventricular tachycardia, it will be all of the sudden. In sinus tachycardia, there is predisposing factor. The patient is febrile, dehydrated. But in supraventricular tachycardia, sudden, the patient having heart failure. Heart failure, tachypnea, tachycardia, tender liver, the patient poor, feeding, sweating, all of this, it will be feature of heart failure. Supraventricular tachycardia, it will be sudden, presented with heart failure. Sinus tachycardia, it will be gradual, presented with fever or dehydration or anemia. This is the features of the sinus tachycardia. How much is the heart rate? Heart depend on the age group. Infant, it will be in sinus tachycardia less than 220 beat per minute. In child, less than 180 beat per minute. But in supraventricular tachycardia, in infant, it will be more than 220 beat per minute. In child, more than 180 beat per minute. ECG, what about the ECG? This is the most important. In sinus, it will be variable PR. Sometimes it will be short, sometimes it will be normal. But in supraventricular tachycardia, fix. no variability, because supramedial cortex no variability, but in sinus there is variability, because actually there is fever up and down, dehydration is corrected or not corrected, anemia is corrected or not corrected. B wave, it will be present and upright in sinus tachycardia, but B wave, it will be actually not present, I cannot identify. If the B waves are present, they will likely to be inverted, it will be like inverted. What is the causes of sinus tachycardia? It's when the patient is anemic, dehydrated, hypovolemic, febrile, hypoxic, even can be shocked. But what about the causes of the supraventricular tachycardia? It will be conduction problem, structural heart disease problem. It will be physiological or electrophysiological problem. So it will be related to re-entry with accessory pathway, called Wolff Parkinsonian, or it will be spontaneous depolarization of the pacemaker sites, cardiac pathology. Sometimes the patient having structural abnormalities like Epstein anomaly, or the patient is receiving medication, sympathomimetic medications like the neonate almost who are giving the caffeine, or the patient is hyperthyroidism. So it will be actually the related supraventricular tachycardia, medication or disease, and disease either is arrhythmia or related to structural heart disease, Epstein anomaly of arrhythmia or accessory pathway, hyperthyroidism and medication like caffeine. X-ray, if you do X-ray, this will be a small heart, but in the supraventricular tachycardia, because the patient having heart failure, it will be large and pulmonary edema. This is evidence of heart failure, large heart and pulmonary edema. So the first step, you have to classify this tachyarrhythmia is narrow complex tachycardia or wide complex tachycardia. Then you have, if narrow complex, you have to differentiate, this is sinus tachy or supraventricular tachy. And the third step, you have to check the causes or the reversible causes of the complex or narrow complex tachycardia. You have actually here, you see, this is it will be reversible H and T. There is 5H and 5T. H, it will be hypovolemia, hypoxia. H, it will be like acidosis, hypoglycemia, hypothermia, hypo or hyperkalemia. T, it will be toxin, tympanade, cardiac tympanade, tension, pneumothorax, thrombosis, coronary or pulmonary, and trauma. This is the reversible causes of the tachyarrhythmia. This is 5H and 5T. You have to actually treat them. It will help you. The fourth, you have to check the stability of the patient, hemodynamic stability, the blood pressure, patient is stable or unstable. Patient is stable, vagal maneuver. And we said this is almost for all the children. For infant, it will be ice bag on the face for the infant and carotid sinus massage or Valsalva maneuver or other maneuvers. It will be for older children. Then if the patient is stable, you have to give adenosine. It will be IV access is present, and you have to give the first dose 0.1 milligram maximum to be 6. If still no response, you have to repeat it. It will be double dose 0.2 milligram maximum, it will be 12 milligram in line close to central circulation, in line central circulation or close to the central circulations. Need continuous ECG and blood pressure monitoring. So if the patient unstable, you have to give cardioversion or supervised cardioversion. If the patient actually amiodarone and procainamide, if above unsuccessful, and esophageal arterial atrial pacing can be performed. So supraventricular tachycardia, we said stable or unstable, patient stable, vagal maneuver, and then give pharmacological management. It will be adenosine. If no response, give amiodarone or procainamide. And if adenosine unsuccessful and the patient unstable, you have to give synchronized cardioversion. You can start it with 0.5 to 1 joule per kg, and you can double the dose if no response to 2 joule per kg. Maximum individual dose, it will be 360 joules. And you first, you have to consult the pediatric cardiology. Actually, this, it will help us in such cases. It will help us in such cases. This is the algorithm, a very important algorithm from the Pulse Pediatric Advanced Life Support. First of all, what are going to do? This patient having tachycardia with Pulse and poor perfusion. First, you have to identify the cause, and you have to maintain the ABC. Then you have to give oxygen, and you have to connect the patient to monitor to check the rhythm and the blood pressure. And also, you have to to insert IV line. If no, you have to insert interosseous, and there is 12 lead ECG. You have to connect it. Then after that, you have to evaluate the QRS. This is narrow complex QRS or wide complex. If narrow complex QRS through the ECG, the possible cause it will be sinus tachy or supraventricular tachycardia. How to differentiate between the sinus tachy and supraventricular tachycardia? Based on what? Based on the ECG, the heart rate. The heart rate, it will be in the supraventricular tachycardia in infant, it will be more than 220 beat per minute, and fixed BR wave, and be fixed BR interval, and B wave cannot detected in supraventricular tachycardia, cannot detect in supraventricular tachycardia. And if wide complex, QRS, this is called it ventricular tachycardia, or it will be supraventricular tachycardia with abnormal conduction. If the case diagnosed as sinus tachycardia, so what are going to do? You have to treat the cause. If supraventricular tachycardia, what are going to do? Depend on the stability of the patient. Patient is stable, vagal maneuver, then after that adenosine. If no response, you have to give the second dose of adenosine, double the dose. If no response, amiodarone and procainamide. If the patient unstable or unsuccessful response to adenosine, you have to give cardioversion. How much you give the joules? It will be 1 joule in the first joule per kg. Then if no response, you have to double the dose. It will be 2 joule per kg. So this is how to approach to supraventricular tachycardia and how to manage supraventricular tachycardia. First of all, you have to identify and treat the cause. ABC, give oxygen, cardiac monitor, insert line, 12 lead ECG. Then check the ECG, QRS is narrow or wide. Narrow, this is what? This is narrow complex tachycardia, only two differential diagnoses, sinus tachy or supraventricular tachy. How to differentiate between them? If heart rate more than 220 beat per minute and BR it's fixed and B wave cannot identifiable, this is supraventricular tachycardia. If the heart rate less than 220 and BR is variable and B wave is upright and present, this is sinus tachycardia. How to treat? If sinus tachycardia, I will treat the cause. Either is anemia, heart failure, dehydrations, or hypoxia, or hypovolemia. I have to treat the cause. If supraventricular tachycardia, how to treat? Depend on the hemodynamic stability of the patient. Is stable or unstable? Stable, you have vagal maneuver and medication or pharmacological management. Adenosine to give the 0.1 milligram per kg, then double the dose, 0.2 milligram up to 12 milligram Then after that, if the patient is not respond or unstable, I will go for cardioversion or synchronized cardioversion. ومن أحياه فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. شكرا، سلام عليكم.